Hello friends, welcome to CyberCat Solutions. In this session, I am going to explain while loop. This while loop is used to execute a set of statements repeatedly as long as a particular condition is true. Let us say if you want to draw concentric circles with the same center point, you want to draw multiple circles with changing radius, then we can use this while loop. Otherwise, if you want to place incremental numbers, let us say 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, continuously, as long as user picks a point, we can use the while loop. Means, while loop is used to execute a set of statements repeatedly until a condition is true. Well, let us try one example. So, let us see the syntax of while loop first of all, how to use this one. So, go to VLIDE. And take a new file and tile it, and I have a small problem with my screen, so I'm stretching it a little to the right side. Well, now let me show you the syntax of while. Open parenthesis, while, and here condition means conditional statement or condition, and then closing parenthesis of while loop. So this is how we need to write. Here condition means say some, let us say we have a variable, as long as variable n is greater than 0, do something. So here comes up the statements, like statement 1 and statement 2, statement 3. You can write any number of statements within the while loop. So as long as n value is greater than 0, that is, this condition becomes true, all the statements within the while block will be executed continuously. Once this condition fails, means n becomes means less than 0, then automatically while loop will get ended and the program control comes out of this while loop. So let us write a small program to draw concentric circles of 10 numbers. Okay, so let me show you how to write it using while loop. So first comment, program to draw concentric circles using while loop. Well, define C colon, say concentric circles, say CC is my command, and end of the program. That's it. Now, in the beginning, we will ask the user to pick a point which we will use it as the center for the circles, and then starting with the radius 1, we will draw 10 circles with the same center point with 10 colors, right? So let us try to write that one. So I am going to ask the user to pick a point. So set Q, P is the point which selected by the user. So get point / n, pick center point for circles. Close. So we have got P, which is the center point for the circles. Now we need to initiate a variable R with radius 1. That is, we are going to use as the radius for circles. So R is equal to 1 means the initial radius. I am going to assume it as 1. So set a variable, set Q, say R as 1. That is the initial radius. Now, as long as R value is less than or equal to 10, it will keep on drawing the circles. So let us see how to do that one. I am going to use while loop like this. Bracket start while less than R 10. Here we will write less than or equal to. Why? Because I want the circle with the 10 radius also to draw. So R is less than or equal to 10. That is my condition. So check this out carefully. R is less than or equal to 10. That is my condition. If R is less than or equal to 10, what to do? First of all, my convention is to close the while loop and then statements. Now I want to draw a circle at P. At P, we need to draw a circle with current R value as radius. So we know how to draw a circle using AutoLISP. So I am going to draw a circle like this. Int make list of properties cons 10 is the base point which is stored in P, and cons 40 is the radius that is in R, and then color cons 62 code, DXF code 62 is used to store the color. So the same R value, whatever the R value, that I am going to take as color also. So radius and color will be same. If the radius is 1, the color will be 1. If the radius is 2, the color will be 2, means yellow. Okay, so what are the basic things required to draw a circle? Base point, that is center point, which is stored in 10, radius, which is stored in 40 code, DXF code 40, and color, that is in 62 code. So those are all enough. So just close this, and we need to tell the system that we are going to draw the circle. So first of all, we need to tell the system that you have to draw a circle. So how to tell that one? Cons G0, that is the type of entity, circle. Without telling what to draw, it won't draw anything. So we need to tell the type of entity to be drawn. So that is circle. So 0 code, 0 DXF code is used to specify the type of object to be drawn. And then 10 is the center point for circle. 40 code stores radius of the circle, 62 color of any entity. So these are all the properties compulsory we need to provide to the LISP program. So with these items, this statement will draw a circle. So for the next round, we need to increase R value by 1, so that in the next round, automatically the next circle will be drawn with increased R value. So to increase R value, set QR as plus R1, means existing R value plus 1. So that will be increased by 1. So what happens here? First of all, that when you load the program, it will ask the user to pick the center point. Once he picks the center point, it comes down and it assigns value 1 to R variable. And then it comes to while loop. Here it will check this condition. If R value is less than or equal to 10, so as it is true, it will get into while loop and it will execute the ntmake statement. So what are all there in ntmake? Type of entity to be drawn is circle, and the base point or the center point is already which is stored in P, and the radius is in R value, that is in 40 code, and color also, whatever the radius, the same number we are going to use for the color also. So we are giving that in 62 DXF code. So with all these properties, the program will draw a circle with the given properties. Well, next we are increasing R value by 1, so that in the next round, once it finishes executing this statement, again it will go and check this condition. If that condition is true, again it will come down and it will execute this statement as well as this statement, means it will draw another circle with the current radius, and then it will increase the R value by 1. So it will, the R value will be increasing by 1, 2, 3, like that up to 10. Once it becomes 11, this condition fails, and automatically the program control comes out of this while loop and the program will be ended. That is how this program is going to stop. Unless you write this condition fails at a point, this program won't come out. It will get into infinite loop. So make sure that your condition will fail at a point of time. Otherwise, the program will never end up. Okay, so make sure that one. So that's all. So these are all enough as of now in my view. So let us start. Check this in the tools, check text in the editor. Checking is done. Well, now go to this and load edit window into AutoCAD, and then CC, that is the command we need to execute in AutoCAD. So go to AutoCAD and type CC at the command prompt and press enter. Now you can see it is asking to pick center point for circles. So I am going to pick over here. You can see directly 10 number of circles are directly drawn over here with 10 different colors. So after picking center point, the R value initialized to 1. So it has drawn a circle with radius 1 as well as color also 1. So you can see that color 1 is red and radius 1. And then the R value, that is, let us go to program. So the R value will be increased over here. Again, it will check the condition. So R value becomes 2. 2 is less than 10. So again, it will come over here, and this statement will be executed once again. So the color R value becomes 2 now. So the color and radius will be 2. So color is 2 as well as radius is 2. Again R value becomes 3 because we are increasing it by 1. So like that up to 10 circles will be drawn, and then once the R value becomes 11, automatically the condition fails and the loop comes out and the program will end. This is how the while loop works. I just want to show you one useful example program. So let us try to write a program to place incremental numbers as text. In the beginning, it will ask you to enter a starting number. The user will enter a number. From there, from that number, it will ask you to pick a point. Whenever you pick a point, it will place a text number on the screen. As long as you pick points, it will keep on increasing value as well as it will place the text numbers in the drawing. So it is nothing but like placing text numbers continuously with an increment. Okay, let us try that program. Well, so write the comment. Program to place incremental number text using while loop. Well, so as usual, define C colon int incremental text. Okay, incremental number text blank and end of the program. So well, so first of all we need to ask the user to enter the starting number, otherwise we can start it with 1 also as of now, like as we did radius 1 in the previous program. And then we need to ask the user to pick a point. Picking point is the condition in while loop, that is what I am going to use in this example. So let us try to ask the user to enter the start number. So set q, say stn starting number, get int backslash n, enter starting number. That's it. So that will ask the user to enter a starting number and it will be stored in stn. Well, then I am going to initiate while loop and I will ask the user to pick a point where to place that text number. So while set qp get point backslash n pick text insertion point, that is the condition. If you pick a point, it will return that point, that will be act as the result of the statement, means it will be true. If you press enter or escape, automatically the result will be null, where while condition will fail and it will come out of the program. That is what we are going to do. Means if you pick a point, automatically it will be assigned to variable p and that will be returned so that the while condition will be true. So it will get into while loop. Well, let me close the while loop over here and then we'll write the statements inside that one. Okay, if the user picks the point, then what to do? We need to place a text at the selected point. So how to place the text? Again, int make. So write like this: int make list cons, type of the entity is text. So what are the basic items required? Cons 10p. This 10 code will store the insertion point of the text. So I am providing insertion point. What are the basic properties to be supplied to draw a text? One is type of entity text, second one is insertion point, then height, and then rotation angle. If you omit the rotation angle, by default it will take 0 as rotation angle. So cons, the height I want is 1 unit and the rotation angle 50 is 0 only. Well, what is the text we want to place? That is in stn, isn't it? So stn is an integer number, so we need to convert it into string before we pass it into this int make properties, because the text entity content must be a string. So cons, the content will be in DXF code 1, and here the content is nothing but starting number. So we need to convert this number from integer to text. So I to a integer to alphabet STN. So this sub function will convert starting number to string. That will be used by the cons function to construct a association list over here. So this will automatically construct an association list with the DXF code 1 and the number, starting number converted into string. So these are enough to create a text entity in AutoLISP. So hope you understood, like type of entity with the 0 DXF code is text, and the insertion point in DXF code that will be in P, and the radius is 1 unit, and the rotation angle is 0.0, and the content of the text, that is starting number, since it is an integer number, we are converting that integer number into alphabet using another function called integer to alphabet, and this sub function will return the value, and that will be used by this construct function to construct an association list. I think all these items are already discussed in the previous sessions. Please go through those sessions carefully. Well, this statement will create a text entity. Well, let us load this and try to, I think we need to increase the starting number by 1. So that is required. So let me write like this: set Q starting number plus starting number 1 means we are increasing this number by 1. Otherwise, you can write this as n, and you can use this n over here, n over here, n over here. This n will hold the starting number, the same will be converted over here into string, and the same for the same number we are adding 1, means we are increasing n value by 1 for the next text placement. Okay, so with that the program is finished. So let us check this program in the tools menu, check text in the editor, checking is done, no errors found. Well, then load it into AutoCAD, and then do remember the command is int, go to AutoCAD, then type int at the command prompt and press enter. Now it is asking to enter the starting number. Let us start with 1. So it is asking to pick text insertion point. I am picking over here. You can see 1 is placed over there. Again, it is asking to pick the text insertion point. I am picking over here. You can see the 2 number is placed. Again, I am picking over here. 3, 4, 5. Press enter. Means the pick point is not taken. So the program has been stopped. Similarly, repeat the same command once again. Say int and start with the number 9. Okay, so I am entering starting number as 9. And now it is asking to pick the text insertion point. I am picking over here. You can see it is starting with a 9. And if you pick another point, means it will ask you to pick the points. So if you keep on picking, as long as you pick, it will keep on placing the text numbers like this. Once you press enter without picking any point, the program will end up. So let us check the program once again. So what we have written over here, we are asking the user to enter starting number, and we are storing the same number in variable called n. And then we have initiated while loop, and as the condition we have written get point function, and we are asking the user to pick a point for the text insertion. If he pick that point, it will be stored in variable p, and that will be the condition, means that will be the true condition. So if the user picks that point, we are going to place a text at the same point with the given number, that is n. So we are using ntmake function. We are providing type of the entity, insertion point, height, rotation angle, and content of the text, that is n value. And then we are increasing n value by 1 so that the next number will be plus 1 number to the current value. Okay, then again while loop will ask you to ask the user to pick another point. If user picks that point, automatically the next number will be placed over there. So this process will continue as long as the user picks points. Once the user press enter without picking any point, the program will end up. Control will come out of the while loop, and program will end up over here. So this is how we use while loop to repeat a set of statements as long as a condition is true, and make sure that your condition fails at a point of time. Otherwise, it won't come out of the program. Well, hope you understood. And if you like this program, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session.